Blessed greeting to Servant House family. Abby and I, we pray all is going well with you and that you're seeing the presence of God in your life so that you can move forward with that which He has given you. We just thank God for you and we pray that you will be encouraged by His word and His will for your life. Let us pray. Father, dear God, I just thank and I just praise you that you are loving, kind, and you give us favor, God. You give us insights, God. Help us to see them so that we can walk the path you've given us so that we will be helped to others in their hour of need. In this pandemic, God, let us walk together, for we need each other. And I just thank you how we can see the unimaginable when we trust in you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I like how our devotional for April the 18th, Saturday, speaks to us from the eyes and the heart of a child. On the Art Link Letter show, there was a little boy that was drawing a picture of God. And Art was start to tell the little boy that no one has ever seen him and they don't know what he looked like. And so the little boy responded was, and quote, "They will when I get through." In other words, he's going to draw them a picture of God and he's going to know. And as I look at that, I think about John 14 is where I take people to many times when they're suffering so that they might find peace and comfort and what God's word is. And I will say anyone in this pandemic, in marriage, in lack of school, not graduating the way you wanted to graduate or the sports, I would say to you, look with love, grace, and mercy unto God, so that He will give you what you need and the peace that surpasses our understanding. Looking at John 14, 1 through 7, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." You've seen Jesus Christ's disciples. Trust Him and you can trust the Father because they are one. He says, "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you." What kind of carpenter is Jesus? You understand that He had that training on earth, but He is the great, awesome carpenter. He's going to create a place for us in heaven. Verse 3, "And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." What a promise. God never fails in His promise. And if we are in Christ, then we are part of that promise. He says He can prepare a place and we're going to go and we're going to be there with Him. Verse 4 says, "And where I go, you know, and the way you know." Then Thomas said to Him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. And how can we know the way?" I think when you be open and honest with God, you're going to get the best answers in your life. Why the pandemic? I don't know. I'm not going to tell you because there was so much evil in the Word of God. I'm not. I don't know everything that God says, how He does it, how He allows it, or He does it. But I want to say one thing, that God is good and we can go to Him. And if we can look unto Him, we will see the path and the strength to move past this pandemic and plan our celebration party. Jesus said to him in verse 6, "I am the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." So He gave them clear direction so they don't need to turn to the left or to the right. You and I shouldn't turn to the left or to the right. We must be looking ahead to God because I believe this. Focus determines everything. So if we'll focus on God, we'll see God for what He has for us. A few thoughts. Number one, believe in Jesus to do the greatest work. Two, Jesus is unimaginable in all totality, and He reveals us as we need. Three, try to live so people see Christ in you. Just because we have a body doesn't mean that's all that people ought to see. Mm-hmm. They ought to see that Holy Spirit, see Jesus Christ, God's Spirit in us. Number two, and next one is, number four, repeat God's word to make it emphatic. If you look at John chapter 13 through 17, God's name is mentioned there 53 times. One would have been good enough. But God repeated over again, it's emphatic. Let's be emphatic in our prayer life, in our walk, in our trust. Okay? I said, Jesus is the best carpenter here on earth and in heaven. He's creating a place for us believers. Being with God means no more death, no more sorrow, no more pain, no more sickness, death, or sinfulness. We are clean and washed by the blood of Jesus Christ. Number 7, Jesus is the only road to heaven. Mm-hmm. Trust only in that.
So Philip says, show us the Father. That's what he said to Jesus. And Jesus' reply was, have I been with you so long and yet you have not known me, Philip? And so the Son is the image of the invisible Father. And we see that as we walk through the Gospels, we see the kindness of Jesus, we see the selflessness of Jesus, we see the sacrifice of Jesus, and we see the love and the zeal of Jesus all throughout the Gospels. And all of those are characteristics of God. So when you see the, when they were seeing the visible Jesus, they were seeing the invisible God. Paul said, imitate me as I imitate Christ. So every day, everywhere, we are to exemplify God to people wherever we meet them. We are not supposed to be changing, you know, our colors depending on who we are. Mm-hmm. Wherever we are, our walk is supposed to be the same. We're supposed to be looking like Jesus so that when they see us, they are seeing God in us.
Amen. Amen. I remember when we was in on a mission trip in Zambia, and we was walking down this road, and a lion came up. He didn't come out of the woods. He came, and you could see him. And I started praying, and I could see feel the glory of heaven. And I had peace, and I stood there, and the lion turned around and went back. I think that's seeing God. God wants us to see him and focus. This pandemic can't own us. Let's focus on God, the unchangeable, the loving, favorable one, so that we'll have the victory.
God, thank you so much for your goodness and your love and your mercy, Father. I just pray, oh Father, that as each of us encounter one another in this crisis, Lord, that when people see us, Lord, they see us as being kind and loving and selfless, Lord, and have a zeal for life, even though we might be going through. But Father, I pray that you be exemplified in us, I pray. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen.